Welcome back to Peaks 47.
So quite pleased with how the barn's coming on. I'm going to move on to now getting it bedded in the scenery. And as you can see, I've just started removing some of the spring down the bottom of this field. I need to put a track in there that the farmer would be going down in his tractor to get his store of his feed for his sheep or whatnot. That'll be the story behind it. Before I move on to doing the track, I just wanted to introduce these range of muds that have just came out from Wwscenics. I need to thank them as my sponsor for sending me out their whole range. I'm going to have a play around with these today. Just wanted to quickly show you the options that you get. So as you can see, there's a range of colours. We've got the browns, the dark browns, we've got clays, light clays, peat, loads of different colours on there. Obviously, you can mix them up and they come in different grades as well, which is quite interesting. So we've got the brown clay fine dry mud. And as it says, it's got a fine grit in it. So this will give you sort of a really fine sort of mud. When this dries, it dries a matte colour. It's air dry, it's acrylic or water based. So this will dry overnight, doesn't need any catalyst in it. So the coarse here, this is the same colour again. As you can see, it's just a bit coarser, got a bit more grit in it. Now the really clever one is the wet. And this has a consistency of probably chocolate spread, melted chocolate, I don't know, peanut butter, something like that. But the clever thing about this wet one is when it's dry, it still stays gloss. So you combine your different coarsenesses, so you're fine in your coarse. And if you want some damp areas, you can apply this over the top, combine them together, put this down first, however you see suit. But this will give you a gloss finish. They've all got this range. So you can see here, the clay comes with a coarse, a wet, and a fine. The aspects of these are still the same. You can mix these up, have a play with them. This is what I'm going to do now. I'm probably going to use the peat and the brown clay, perhaps the light brown as well. I'm going to mix it up a little bit, see how I get on. I'm going to use this in conjunction with building sand. I think I'm going to put some damp mud down here, so if it's at the bottom of the hill, and maybe some dry muds on the other side of the path. Really looking forward to trying these out. So I'm just going to crack on with it now, really, see what I come up with. So the mix I've done for this is building sand, a bit of grout and a bit of roasted mud out the garden, really fine powdery mud, and I've just added it to this sand. I usually would put it on with a sprinkler, but I want to keep this really local. So I'm going to actually just put this on by hand, glue this down, and then I'm going to add the muds over the top. I think that's the right way of doing it. So I have to put this down, leave it 24 hours, come back tomorrow, and then I can really start playing with the muds, getting some tufts in between the tracks, get some gauze brush probably up against this fencing and some other bits and bobs. Hopefully, should really look pretty good. Really need to get this bedded in properly as well, but I'm going to do the messy stuff first and leave that out the way. Right, so all my building sand is dry now, so I can start adding some muds and some Wwscenics. So I think I'm going to put some wet, some patches of wet in the low spots where the track tyres are, some drier mud, or actually some wetter mud up here, and perhaps some drier muds along here. So I've been having a play with a syringe, and it seems to the wet muds come out of the syringe quite well. So I'm going to try that first, and I'm just going to place it just in random spots and just fill up these tracks, and then perhaps use a paintbrush if needs be, just to spread it round a little bit.